Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let me show you how to create a ringtone from a song in iTunes. So here's a way to create a ringtone from a song that you have in iTunes. It works on songs that you've ripped into iTunes from a CD or brought in as a raw file from some other source, or even a song that you purchased on iTunes. It doesn't work for songs that you're listening to with Apple Music. So I'm actually going to do this demonstrating with a song that I bought on iTunes just so you can see it works there. And of course it works in those other cases as well. So I've got this song right here. Now notice I'm using iTunes Match, so I've got these little cloud downloads here. I've made sure I've clicked on it for this song, so now that I have a copy of this song on my hard drive ready to go. It won't work until you do that. So if you see the little cloud thing there, because you purchased the song but you haven't downloaded it to this particular machine, or because you're using iTunes Match and it's not currently on the machine, you need to download it first. So I can see I have that for this. Now I want to control click on the song and I get a whole bunch of different options here. So I could just go right to Show in Finder and it will reveal the file, but if I started creating a ringtone from that file that's there, it actually won't work. Instead, I have to do this thing here where I use the Create AAC version first. So I'm going to do that and you can see it's going to create a duplicate. And you can see this was the original and you can see the duplicate is here. Note that if you go into iTunes Preferences here and you go to Import Settings, you have to have your import settings, I believe, set to AAC encoder for this to work. It should be there by default, but if you've changed it to something else, set it back here so you get that option there when you control click. So now that I've got that, I've got two copies of the song here. I'm going to control click on it again and say Show in Finder. And it will open up the folder where that song is. And you can actually see I've got two versions of the song here. I'll switch to List View and you can see obviously this is the new one because it has appended the number 1 to it. And this is the original one. You can see this is the one I just downloaded first and then 6 minutes later I converted it. So this is the new one and this is the one that I want to work with to create a ringtone. So what I need to do next here is I need to trim this because a ringtone needs to be short. I can do that in a lot of different apps. If you have different sound editing apps, you can use almost any one to do that, and you can use GarageBand certainly to do it. But a simpler way is to use QuickTime Player. So I'm going to open with, I controlled click, and I'm going to select open with here, and I'm going to do QuickTime Player. I could drag and drop it to QuickTime Player. I have it right here in the dock. I could have done that. And here I have the entire song. And I'm going to immediately go to the trim function, edit trim or command T, and I get this trim interface here. I can stretch the right side of the window so it's easier to see where I'm trimming. So I'm not going to listen to it here because if I listen to the song here, it'll be on the video and that'll get picked up by YouTube and you're not supposed to do that. So I'm just going to just trim a random section here to about 20 seconds. You can go up to about 30 seconds. You want to keep it short. It's just for a ringtone. But you definitely, if you having trouble getting it into your iPhone and it's longer than that, then you probably have something that's too long. So I usually go to about 20 seconds and I'll hit trim. So now I've got a smaller section here, 9 seconds of that song. And I'm going to now save it. Actually, anything I do with it, I'm going to have to save because I've trimmed it. It's not going to just save at over the existing version. And I want to save it to somewhere, so I'm going to save it to the desktop and I'm just going to call it something and save it out. And there it appears on my desktop. So now I want to work with this file here, and what I want to do is I want to change the file extension. .m4a tells iTunes that it's a song. I want to actually rename it .m4r. And that tells iTunes it's a ringtone. I'll get a warning and I'll say yes, I want to use that. Now I go back into iTunes here and I'm going to click on the three dots here at the top. Instead of viewing music, I'm going to go and view tones. And you can see I've got no tones here saved in iTunes. All I need to do is drag and drop the M4R in here. And now in my iTunes library, I have one tone. And now that I've got it in my iTunes library, I can move that to my iPhone. Now I've got my iPhone here at the top. I'm going to select that and now I've got a left sidebar that shows me settings for the iPhone, and I can look at all the different settings here, and the one I want is the one called Tones. And I want to set it to Sync Tones, and I can set all tones, which just I'll take everything that's in my iTunes library, or the selected ones. I only have that one, of course, and that'll be selected, and now I can hit apply and it will sync it to that iPhone. So now if we look on that iPhone under settings and go down to sounds, I can set the ringtone, and you can see right there, right above the default ringtones, is the song that I've chosen. So now I've got that song there, and I can set it to a ringtone or some other alert tone, anything you can use ringtone for on your iPhone or iPad. So now back on my Mac, I want to get rid of that extra copy of the song. I don't really want that anymore. I could do that here. An easier way to do it just to clear your iTunes library nicely is to go back, and I remember it was the first one here that was the copy, so I'm just going to hit delete there, and I'm going to delete the song, say yes, move to the trash, and you can see in the finder here it moved that copy to the trash. So now I've cleaned up iTunes and I've cleaned up the finder there. I maybe instead of putting this on the desktop, I could have put this into a ringtones folder in my documents folder just to be a little neater, or depending upon how you have iTunes set up, it would have just copied that into your library anyway, so you won't even need this extra version of the ringtone.